Hi guys, good day. It's me, Teacher MJ. Our topic for today class is we're going to find the increase and the percentage of increase in this given table. So without further ado, let's do this topic. Now the next part of our video class is still we're going to complete the table, but this will be quite complicated class because in number 1, you're told to find the increase and the percentage increase. But for number 2 class, you don't have the new value as well as the increase in value. For number 3, you don't have the original value and you don't have the percentage increase. So this will be quite complicated class for number 2. But once again class, do not be worried with this example number 2 because we will be explaining this one class step by step, and I will just put the link class on the description down below on how to solve this one class. Let's focus first on the part 1 class. Alright, so we have given original value and the new value. So number 1, given original value, that's 100, new value, that's 120. We're told to find the increase in value. So to find the increase in value, just simply subtract this one class. New value minus original value. So new value minus original value, as you can see, 120 minus 100, that would be 20, right? Once again, new value minus original value. So 120 minus 100, therefore the increase in value, that would be 20. Alright, so that's 20, and to get the percentage increase, this will be the formula. So new value, that's 120, minus original value, minus 100, over original value, that's 100, times 100. Alright, so once again class, the formula in percentage increase, new value minus original value, divide, always divide by original value, times 100. So 120 minus 100, divide 100 times 100. So 120 minus 100, that's 20. Divide 100, then multiplied by 100. So 20 divided by 100. Let's just use our calculator class. So I hope that your teacher will allow you to use calculator. So 20 divide 100, that would be 0.2. So this is 0.2 times 100. So just simply move decimal point class left to right. Twice, if you multiply it by 100, 1, then 2, so this will be 20%. So our answer class, that would be 20%. Or you can use your calculator, 0.2 times 100, of course, you will get 20. Alright, so the answer for number 1, that is 20%. Alright, let's have number 2. So, 62. For new value and original value, that's 54. Once again, subtract to get the increase in value, new value minus original value. So 62, new value, 0.1, minus original value, that's 54. And you will get the increase in value. So let's subtract using our cell phone. So you can use your calculator there, class. So 62.1 minus 54, you will get 8.1. 8.1. So once again, the increase in value, that would be 8.1. So this is 8.1. And then to get the percentage increase, simply substitute the value class, new value, that's 62.1. Alright, and then original value, that's 54 minus 54. And then divide by original value, that's 54, multiplied by 100. Alright, so 62.1 minus 54. So once again, simply use your calculator. So I hope, class, that your teacher will allow you to use calculator, especially, class, with this one. You are dealing with decimals. This will be quite complicated. So 62.1 minus 54, that would be 8.1. Then divide by original value, that's 54 times 100. So 8.1 divided by 54. So you will have 0.15 multiplied by 100, okay, times 100, you will get 15%. Or just simply move this one left to right, 1, then 2, that would be 15. Then put percent. That's 15% plus for example number 2. All right, so 15%. Let's have example number 3. So we have 500 and then 250. Of course, if we subtract this one to get the increase in value, 500 minus 250, that would be 250, right? Okay, 500 minus 250, that would be 250. So the increase in value, that would be 250. So let's use this one, the formula, to get the percentage increase. So new value, that's 500, minus original value, that's 250, over, divide by original value, that's 250, times 100. So 500 minus 250, that's 250, divide 250, times 100, so 250 divided by 250, of course, that's 1, right? So 1 times 100, of course, 1 times 100, class. What's the answer, class? That's correct, that would be 100%. Alright, so for number 3, class, the answer is 100%. Alright, let's have number 4. So could you try this one, class, number 5, and you put your answer in the comment section down below, class. Let me check, class, if you really understand this topic. So very easy, right, for this one. If you have your calculator, class, I think this will be very easy for you, class, for example, for this kind of example, class. Since you just simply subtract new value minus original value, and then once you get the increase in value, use this formula, okay, use this formula to find the percentage increase. Alright, number 4. So let's subtract new value minus original value to get increase in value. So increase in value. So increase in value. In value, that would be new value minus original value. So new value, that's 317.25 minus original value, that's 235. So you simply use your cell phone or calculator. So this will be 317.25 minus 235. So this will be 82.25. Alright, so the increase in value, that would be 82.25. And then use this formula to find the percentage increase. So this will be new value, that's 317.25 minus 235 for the original value, divide original value, that's 235 times 100. So 317.25 minus 235, we have our answer a while ago, that's 82.25. divide 235 times 100. So let's divide this using our cell phone. So 82.25 divide 235, so you will get 0.35 times 100. Of course, 0.35 times 100, that would be 35, right? You simply move this decimal point left to right twice. 1, then 2, that would be 35, then you put percent. Once again, once you move plus this decimal point, 1, 2, the point plus will be here after the whole number. So that's why you have 35%. That's it, class. All set. For example, number 4. So you try this one, class, number 5. Let me check, class, if you understand our topic. You try this one and you put your answer in the comment section down below. Let me check, class, if you really understand this one. Alright, so I hope you learned something new today. If you like this video, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. You share it to your friends and to your classmates so that we can help more students. Once again, class, this is Teacher MJ. Have a great day, class. Goodbye for now. Bye-bye.